Welcome to our YouTube channel.
This is our first video.
Yay! I'm Adriana.
I'm Katie. And we're
Kadriana. So we're gonna be teaching you guys how to use
a neck collar.
A neck collar today. So,
what a neck collar is used for normally.
Yeah.
So, normally a neck collar would be used to stabilize the neck of somebody who's either got into a car accident,
who's fallen from like a tree or a building or something.
Yeah, just anybody's neck that you need to stabilize, because if you move it, it will get worse because you don't really know the condition of it yet.
And it's used in trauma.
Mm-hmm.
So like the examples that we just gave you.
Those are all like trauma incidents. So we learned this in our EMT class, and we also learned that anytime it's like any accident, like a fall especially, to always put a neck collar, even if you're not sure, just to be safe.
It's always better to be safe than sorry.
Yeah. So about it, I guess we could talk about like what it's
Okay. So it looks like this when it's out the packet, and then it's able to sort of, you know, obviously, to go on your neck. I'm so sorry. And then right here is sort of like the measurements, and this is what we use to
lock it in place.
And then this is just, you know, once you Velcro it, it comes here, mm-hmm. so that it stays in like the circle.
And then these are like the type of levels that one's neck would be here. So there's tall, regular, short, and necklace as in you don't have a neck, not like a necklace. Necklace, it says it here. Necklace, as in.
Oh, well, we're usually
no
we're
neck.
Calling it no neck. Okay.
So the way you would measure to put it on somebody's neck. Do you want me to do it on you? Our mannequin, Adriana, with her nice neck. So the way you would want to measure it is, you have like different ways. You can do it like this by starting at the jawline to the shoulder. So.
The collarbone.
No, your shoulder. The collarbone's all the way down here.
Oh. I know, but the beginning of it.
So, you'd want to measure. Her neck's, like, turning, so it's, like, making it longer. But it would be like this. That's great. And then you'd want to measure it on here. So, you'd want to start at the bottom of the plastic. And hers is a regular because you're starting at the bottom of the plastic and then it'll like go on whichever one it is. So now I'm gonna adjust it to regular. Okay, right there. And then you wanna lock it. You always wanna make sure that it's locked. And now to put it on.
Sorry.
So here you wanna stabilize it. Hold it there. You want to make sure that is in the middle. Then at the bottom of your chin. You good?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, and then you want to rub.
It has to be 100% skin to collar contact too, for it to be effective. Damn.
Sorry, her hair is kind of like in the way.
Are you apologizing to them and not me?
<I'm sorry. laughs> Okay. And then there you go. So now when she moves, her like neck will be in place, like, cause now it'll be like her whole body shifting. Like, go try to move. She's moving, but her neck is intact.
Okay.
And here is like the middle. You also want to check for three things before putting the neck collar on, and it would be trach shift, which is here. You would want to feel, and you would just feel if the trachea was shifted or not, because it should be in place.
We would check for a step off, so at the back of the neck,
can they see? Yes, so in the back of the neck, you have this hole available, and you could feel that.
So it would just feel like, literally like overlapping, so you would feel like a bump, and all of these things that we're mentioning, you need to, yeah, thank you.
You can take this off right now.